building is a topic that's come up a lot in Dream World. It's one of the core mechanics, you know, of the game that we encourage players to really take a deep dive into. We've talked about terraforming and how we can combine that with building to make some really cool builds. We've looked at the many different biomes that you can make builds in. And we've also gone over the basics of building, how to utilize, you know, the different resources in Dream World, the many different resources to customize your build pieces, making them have different textures, different looks, you know, some shine to them, mixing and matching different assets to make really interesting builds. And today, we'll be talking about building again. However, we'll be doing it a little bit different today. Today, we'll be taking a look at the many builds that our players have constructed throughout the different biomes of Dream World. Whether it be some of the newer builds or builds that have been around for a while, whether it be smaller builds or bigger builds, let's take a look at some amazing community creations that really showcase the spirit of building in Dream World. When you spawn into the City of Elysium, you know, upon first entering the game, you're going to notice a lot of very interesting architecture. However, the building we're going to focus on is the one with the blue roof. This is GigaBear's Welcome Center. It's been currently updated to have pumpkins out front as Halloween is approaching soon. But this build is mainly a place for new players and, you know, current players to just have a space to hang out in. First, we'll take a look here at this sitting area. This uses, you know, some of the seat assets, some, you know, some tabletop assets, a lot of interior assets. Let's take a seat and just enjoy the view for a second. We then have this cooking station here, where you'll be able to make any type of food that you can make in the game. If we go to the back of the build, we can see we have some balcony space here to look out at the City of Elysium, the floating island, as well as just observe the horizon. At the very back of the build, there's a little porch area here with a texture that looks very bright and colorful, almost a little trippy. I'll let you have a look at it for a second. We then come to some more crafting benches, as well as a trading station, as well as more balcony space. And then even a little chessboard area, you know, it's got some nice polished wood there, looks like conifer. A cool little design to throw into a community center. And lastly, before we leave, we want to make sure to pick up the Spirit Orb to collect some Dream Essence to complete the scavenger hunt that's actually active at this build. If we look here, you'll see that there's some berry bushes where we can harvest some food. Now that we've taken a look at the Welcome Center, let's have a look at another build that's actually surrounding the City of Elysium. If we take the airstream all the way up in the city, we can actually notice a floating build. Let's see if we can get over there. Here we find new player 00296's Starbase. This build is in the shape of a star and has some cool lighting built into the walls. There's also some incredible views to be seen here. We have some openings here that we can actually climb up from the, you know, first floor and get to the roof. I really love how the rays of sunshine come through the windows in this build. Let's climb up to the roof though and see what we can see there. I personally really like the use of building assets to, you know, create these intertwined, like, slanted rafter designs. So there you have it. That's a pretty awesome Starbase build. Let's see what other builds we can find as we, you know, explore the lands of Dream World. As we float above the desert biomes below the city of Elysium, we come across this little build. It really caught my eye because it's kind of a smorgasbord of all the different, you know, resources. There's lots of birch wood, flint being used here, some flowers, some wood, lots of shiny materials. It even looks like the foundations are made from sticks. We'll get the full 360 view just to see all the different resources being used, you know, intertwined with the assets here. But this build really goes to show how textures can vary with the same build piece based on what resource you use. We also have a garden in front of this home we'll take a look right now. When I was wandering outside of a desert biome, I was actually able to find this nice little redwood base, but since I last saw it, it's actually been upgraded. Tarnatox Manor can be found at an island at the base of a really cool mountain range. Features both a nice redwood build as well as a little treehouse area that we'll take a look at in a second. These treehouses utilize terraforming to create the poles in the center and then have, you know, building assets built around them. It looks like it's not quite done yet, but what's here right now is pretty awesome, so let's have a look. The bulk of it's made up of redwood. I personally really love the look of redwood, especially polished redwood. And while this isn't polished, it still looks pretty cool. There's even a little bit of birch wood that's been accented around it. We can see the spirit lantern has been enlarged and placed at the back of the build right against a tree. I don't know, there's something about this that I really like. We got a nice little garden area in front of the house, which adds a little bit of a homey feel to it. Let's head through the nice and shiny flint door to check out the interior. We're met with a nice open area, some redwood walls, and even some red lighting to kind of complement that. If we take a look at this round side room here, we can see, first of all, a table asset that utilizes grass as a resource, as well as a nice little fruit bowl. There's some peppers in there, it looks like. For the floor, we've got a mix of both birch and conifer wood, it appears. And these redwood torches, I think, are used very, very well. The lighting complements the redwood that, you know, makes up a majority of the room. We can also see some incorporation of chandelier lighting. What was really interesting about the interior of the base, though, was the actual basement area, which utilizes some stone and, you know, has all the crafting stations, as well as a bed, because what feels more homey than a bed? If we come back outside, we'll see a couple of statues out in the water, as well as a nice little drawbridge going across the river here. All in all, this is a really amazing build. Thank you, Tarnatox, for playing Dreamworld. For the next build we're going to take a look at, this is Ruru's Palace, located right under the city of Elysium. I personally really love the use of the golden statues that are kind of adorned alongside the walkway that leads to the actual tower. A really cool use of different build pieces here. Let's also make sure to complete the scavenger hunt to collect some dream essence. Walking around this base, we can see a lot of attention to detail. We can see that all the build pieces have been blended very, very well together. The good thing about the build pieces in Dreamworld is that they're able to complement each other, which definitely allows for creativity to make bases like this one. We can also see a very cool placement of the reliquary here. Let's go ahead and light that to get some more dream essence. Now, let's climb the tower and see what kind of views we can get from the top. Leaving the palace, if we return into the desert, you can see this interesting looking build in the distance. When I got closer, I realized I was looking at a bug build. That's right, this base was actually built to look like some sort of bug. There's a very clever use of pillars here, which make up the antlers and the legs, as well as the use of the roof to kind of resemble a head. This is a great example of how flexible and creative you can get with your builds in Dreamworld. So to Fireblade, great work on your Centipede of Doom. Let's go back out exploring though for our next build. Our next build we're gonna take a look at is building in Dreamworld on a massive scale. And I personally discovered it out of nowhere. It completely surprised me. This is Terrace HD's base. There's a use of stone build pieces here, positioned right up against the mountain. Many, many different build pieces being used here and intertwined to give off kind of like a mountain castle sort of vibe. That's the cool thing about the different build pieces in Dreamworld is that you can actually have like themed build pieces, like with that big tower, certain styles of build pieces. You know, there's Roman architecture build pieces, there's castle build pieces. We can see these, you know, flaming open braziers here provide a great lighting effect, as well as the door having a great lighting effect. If we enter though, we see some massive pillars going up to the roof. I get a very big Lord of the Rings vibe from this base. You know, like you think of Moria or the Misty Mountains. It seems like a big inspiration for this build. Let's head deeper in and see what's in this cavern. Wow, the terraforming here is incredible. Many different pathways and lava falls even that have been made. You might be hesitant to jump into the lava pits like I was here. However, don't worry, this isn't lava, it's just torches that have been placed to create a really good lighting effect. Now, if we head deep into this little cavern, you'll notice that many different build pieces have been combined to actually make a dragon. Very creative use of different shapes here. There's even a little goblin right here helping the dragon guard all this treasure. Such an amazing build, a huge variety of different build pieces and, you know, different textures used here. But let's go and check out another build. While exploring the lands between, you know, the mountains and forests around the 00 marker, you might start to find these walkways of foundation. Let's actually follow this one and see where it leads. So we see this archway here that's really clean, really sleek. This isn't the build we're gonna be checking out though. That build is coming right up. At the coordinate 00, you'll find Gemini's tower build. The sheer amount of different resources used and just the farming that went into making this base is absolutely incredible. I will just let the build speak for itself. Has kind of a cavern down here. You can, you know, jump into the water and travel down the shaft. You can use the climbing mechanic to travel all the way up the interior of the tower, stopping to collect dream essence from the reliquaries that lead up to the top. The views from the top of this tower, though, are just... Ooh, I love them. You can see the different mountain ranges, you know, in the distance, you know, out from the lake that this is, you know, positioned in, as well as you can see the city of Elysium in the sky. There you have it, though, everybody. That is all of the player builds that we are going to be looking at today. We got to see lots of creativity and, you know, very interesting design choices in the bases, and the builders that made these bases did a really, really good job. If you choose to play Dreamworld for yourself, you'll be able to get in-game and actually explore the lands and even look at bases like some of the ones that we looked at today. Or you can even build your own, you know, big builds or really cool smaller builds, where players will be able to stop by and check your build out. If you like this video, make sure to subscribe to the channel and let us know if you want to see a version 2 where we check out even more player builds. If you want to try Dreamworld out for yourself, if you like what you saw, you know, feel free to go to the description of the video. There'll be a link to the website. There you'll be able to get info about how to actually play Dreamworld for yourself. But thank you so much for watching, Dreamers. We will see you in the next video. Have a good day, everybody. Bye-bye.